Yo, good afternoon, viewers of YouTube. My name is Tyler of Chico Crypto, and you know the drill. Grab yourself a brewski, crack it open, and it's time for Crypto and a Cold One. Today's featured brew is for the Dutchies from Holland, Heineken Brewery, Heineken. I like Heineken, always have, so I'm gonna like it. Cheers. So, Elastos. It's hands down my favorite cryptocurrency project. The goal of the project is to create a decentralized autonomous internet that can host dApps and doesn't rely on traditional ways of sending network information. The combination of tech, a unique runtime built with C-based virtual machines, a P2P network carrier, and blockchain IDs allow the concept to come to fruition. If you haven't watched the Chico Crypto series of videos on Elastos, I would recommend checking it out to get a deep understanding of each of the critical components to the Elastos ecosystem. Link to all the videos is in the description. Today, I would like to paint a picture of how important the end of this year and the beginning of next year will be for Elastos. The Elastos main chain in its current form is a pure proof-of-work sidechain that is merge mined with the Bitcoin blockchain. This means that the hashing power of the miners who adopt the merge mining code for their mining machines will secure not only the Bitcoin blockchain, but the main chain of Elastos too. Guess who is a faithful supporter of this merge mining? The all-powerful Jihan Wu, CEO of Bitmain. Jihan is quoted as saying, "At Bitmain, we strive to be at the forefront of recognizing new, innovative technologies in the blockchain space, as well as the cutting-edge teams leading the way to mainstream adoption. Elastos is one of those projects. There are very few projects we have opened our community up to, and there are only three merged mined with Bitmain. So, who are those three? Namecoin, Rootstock, and now Elastos. Bitmain is the owner and operator of two of the largest Bitcoin mining pools on the Bitcoin network, BTC.com and AntPool. If we take a glance at the hashing distribution chart based on pools, we can see that those two pools combined account for nearly one-third of the Bitcoin hashing power. Now, BTC.com has already commenced merge mining and is currently securing the Elastos main chain. In December, just a mere month away, Bitmain will be going live with the merge mining partnership, with both BTC.com and AntPool will be merge mined with Bitcoin. This means that the miners who are mining Bitcoin will also be rewarded with a number of Elastos tokens based on their hashing contribution to the pool. This also means people, usually very knowledgeable about crypto, are going to be introduced to Elastos. This alone will bring a ton of awareness and publicity to the project. Now, if you're a Bitcoin miner, you can join the BTC.com mining pool and contribute to securing the main chain of Elastos, but you aren't rewarded just yet. From my research and understanding, Bitmain is in the process of updating the website so miners can submit their Elastos addresses to claim their tokens. Bitmain will not keep any Elastos, and they will be given to the miners, including the Elastos that were mined before, if they submit their addresses. December is going to be hot. I can feel it. With all this heat, you would think things couldn't get any hotter for Elastos, right? Wrong. In the last weekly update that Elastos posted, there are some things we should definitely analyze and get excited about. Number one is Elastos has determined the delegated proof of stake UI design and interface definitions, and started the voting function development. To understand what is going on, we need to understand that the Elastos main chain will evolve from a pure proof of work, that is merge mined, to an auxiliary proof of work with delegated proof of stake. In the early stage of merge mining, it is critical that Elastos main chain is secure and doesn't have the potential to hard fork. The partnership with Jihan and Bitmain stop a hard fork dead in its tracks. Once the DPoS is applied to the main chain, it will become virtually impossible to hard fork the Elastos main chain. This is also the same time the complete vision of merge mining will take hold, and merge mining will be allowed on different pools, and to the lone miner running his own farm at home. Besides creating an unforkable blockchain, DPoS will allow the Elastos main chain to escape fears of network clogs due to high traffic loads being put on a pure proof-of-work blockchain. Essentially, what this means is Elastos utilizes the sidechain structure for all the dApps and the ecosystem components like IDs. Early next year, mainchain Elastos holders will jointly elect a certain number of arbitrator nodes. This is where the delegates of the proof of stake come in. The delegates are the arbitrator nodes. These arbitrator nodes are responsible for signing of token withdrawals from the mainchain to the sidechain and from the sidechain back to the mainchain. The main chain of Elastos will always be locked into using proof of work to reach consensus during asset transfer from the main chain to the side chain. So to understand this, we have the main chain of Elastos. A transaction is invoked to transfer tokens to a side chain. The main chain's miner nodes packages the transaction and creates a block. The arbitrator on duty, which is elected, obtains the transaction and address details and constructs a new transaction to send to the side chain. The sidechain node packages the transaction and creates a block. After sufficient confirmations, the sidechain receiver address should have the tokens in their account. What about transfers from the sidechain to the main chain? With future updates, sidechains will be able to choose any consensus to do asset transfers back to the main chain. In the current form, only proof of work is supported, but all consensus mechanisms will be supported, with the next one in the pipeline being DPoS. To walk us through a transfer, first, a transaction is created, withdrawing a certain number of tokens from the sidechain, and this is sent to the sidechain miner nodes who package the transaction in a block. After the required amount of confirmations, the arbitrator on duty node gets the transaction from the sidechain node. This arbitrator on duty makes a new transaction based on the details of the transaction they received. They then broadcast the new transaction to all other arbitrator nodes for signatures, and once two-thirds of the nodes confirm and sign it, they submit the transaction to the main chain. Finally, miners of the main chain generate a block with the transaction, and after the required number of confirmations, the transfer of assets is completed to the main chain address. It's obvious that the arbitrator nodes are going to play a critical role, and a highly functioning, utilized smart web would mean lots of transaction fees for those voted in nodes. These nodes will rotate on a regular schedule, and to be considered for one, first you need to have enough computing power and the network resources to be able to run at least one main chain node and X number of nodes corresponding to X number of side chains. Computational power is a must. And people were arguing, what is the use of the Elastos token? Governance is the use. Holding Elastos tokens gives you a voice in the future of the platform, and this will extend beyond voting in arbitrator nodes. Well, viewers, I hope this gives you a clear picture of why the next few months are going to be exhilarating. Elastos has created a unique blockchain structure that will allow dApps to run unhinged the way they were meant to. Cheers, and as always, I will see you next time.